Meat bicycle!
Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode of the Legendary Run here on Borderlands the pre-sequel. So, we finished off the last episode at the catch 'em all, Pokemon. We finished off the last episode at here in Virago Solitude, and I've just got a skill point actually from leveling up off these guys, these guardians. We're doing the Pokemon mission anyway. We have got this mission and one more to do in Lunar Launching Station, and that is it. We have finished nearly all the missions in the vanilla game, apart from the little arena battle in Outlands Canyon. What do you call them? The Circle of Duty or whatever you call them, them kind of things. But we're not going to do that on camera, I don't think. We're going to head over to Claptastic Voyage DLC today, start that out, and our legendary today will be farming Flame Knuckle in Holodome Round 1 for his legendary Nukem rocket launcher. Catch him up, Pokemon. I am going to do that every single time as well for some reason. It just brings back memories. So plenty to do today anyway. Really really happy at the progress as well. We've still got Iwajira to farm as well at some point, but I want to start heading out into the Claptastic Voyage DLC for sure. This mission's so easy, I forgot how easy it actually is. Cryo Rafe, fair enough. We can do that. Guardian Raf, right, let's get him down. I think you've got to get him down. You might just be able to chuck a ball at them, but I don't know. I'm just feel it should be easier doing it like that. Right, where is this guy going to be? Because he was following me. He's there, look. Come on, let me hand it in.
It's me, Skirwin. Yeah, we're all done here. We got everything you need. No worries. See you there.
Come on.
Let's head back to the pickup point. The blokes are on their way to grab what we bagged. I don't know, mate. This whole thing doesn't sit right with me. These blokes are going to run a load of tests on these guardians so they can scratch their heads and figure out the best.
Well, now you're changing your mind.
And I just don't think I can be a part of that. I mean, look at the beautiful little blighters. Who'd want to lift a finger to hurt it?
Well, they're trying to kill you enough. Right, let's go to the pickup point. Where is the pickup point? It must be where I picked up the mission. There is a doll chest down there, I think. Or is it the other one? No, I think it's down here. Let's have a look. Yep, there is a doll chest down here. Nice. Let's grab some ammo, actually, because I've just used all mine. Farming the guardians. No, it's not. It's a green and a blue. Come on, Claptrap. You should know we're only after legendaries here. Right, here we go, then. Pickup point reached. Master Poacher.
So I can think seriously? You want to just hand him over? Blimey.
Okay. I thought I had to kill him or something. I can't remember doing that mission for a long time, so I'll go turn that in then. I think you... Did you get a choice? I'm not sure if you got a choice or not, but hey, who cares? We're not here to make decisions, we're just here to hand missions in. Boom. Nearly got your head then. Nearly got your head.
Oh, I got your number now, mate. I know your kind. I don't know how you sleep.
Well, you were the one that gave me the mission, you stupid twit. Right. To Virago then. Off we go. And then, like I said, we'll just head into Claptastic Voyage very quickly. We might not get a lot done in there, but because the Holodome Round's going to take a while to actually do, and I want to get a couple of runs done of them for sure. We're going to have to make that read-only as well before we do anything. Right, let's pick up the eyepieces. And then, there's just two of them. And then, yeah, we can head on out. and activate Claptastic Voyage DLC. I'm really looking forward to going back into that and farming in there. Have I got that already? No, I haven't. Where is it? Oh, it's down there. I thought it was at the top. Right, next area. Keep going. Can I get up here? No, I can't. Wow, there's something screwing me over there. Ow, just let me run. Thank you. I don't know why I wanted to be up here so badly, but I didn't know you could get up there, actually. You're not supposed to be able to, I don't think. Right, let's just go. Stop messing about on this episode of Jumps and Spots. Right, I want to be up here. Boom. And I'm going to go kill Power Suit Noob again, just because I like killing him. Okay. You mad, Jack? Oh, research and development. Right. Oh, yeah, I remember this mission. Right, let's go ahead over there then. You go away. That was a quick kill. I was going to quit out and come back in then, but by the time we come back in, we'll nearly be there anyway. I forgot we had to head over there. Right, research and development. Is this the one where you've got to go? Yes, I think this is the one where you've got to go all the way up here. Is it round the corner? Yeah, this eye can put you down, actually. It can explode. We'll go to the biolab in a minute. We'll take a ram route and farm the two bosses, though. You never know when you're going to get something good. Right, Tiny Destroyer. No Moonlight Saga. Fair enough. What about the X-Stalker? We'll open these two chests up as well while we're here. Screw it, why not? I hate that camera. Right. Mr. X-Stalker. It's been a long time since we saw you last. I've got no grenade mod equipped, have I? Wow, this blowfly's not doing very well. Alright, it's getting better. No class mod either. Fine. We'll grab this while we're here though, if we haven't already. No, we've already got it. Right, two chests to open then, and then we'll head to the bio lab. You guys can stay over there. Why have I not got a grenade equipped? Oh yeah, because I had the monster hunter. 23. Right. Nothing at all. Right, to the bio lab. No more distractions. I've also just thought as well, we need to farm for the Four Seasons and the bonus package as well. So yeah, that could be an episode or two as well. We need to get all of them. So that'll be fun, trying to find blooming badass Torgs and Kragans. But yeah, that is another... That's a dredger. That is another couple of episodes as well. So we've still got plenty to do, really. It's just finding those gits. So that's another thing we can do in a couple of episodes. It's wrong. I always get that wrong. I always go to that room and it's the other one. I'm going to stand out of the way of this thing as well, because I remember last time I came here, I got too close to it, it exploded and it put me down. Now, solder them together with an energy suture. Okay, it's sutured. Get it on the mount so we can shoot it down the testing range. Okay. Chill, Jack. Oh. Pick it up. And destroy. Almost there. Now shoot it with a laser gun. If you need a laser gun, there should... Oh, God. Oh, I have got a laser gun. Where is my ZX-1? I want that ZX-1. Nearby. The scientists have to kill their own creations a lot more than you'd think. That is a laser weapon. Is that not classed as a... Is that not classed as a laser weapon? Okay, I ain't got any other lasers. ZX-1 is a laser. So why won't that work? Right, let's see if I've got any other laser weapons that aren't a ZX-1. No, no. Okay. I'll have to grab one of these then. Let's. Ow, it's done it again. Told you, if you get too close. Luckily, this guy's here to help me, though. Well, that sucked. So, why would it do it with a ZX... Why wouldn't it do it with a ZX-1? I don't get that. Unless I had to get closer to it. I don't know. It's supposed, maybe supposed to blow you up. Wow, you are a badass. And badass, you should not scream like that. Right, there is a chest to open up the top. I might have a quick run there, just in case. You never know, I like opening chests up, and then we'll head to hand this in and head to Claptastic Voyage. There we go, let's do some quick scoping on the way. Oh, beautiful. Beautiful little quick scope. Might change my name to 360 YOLO Swag. Oh, look at that. Pro, ready for this turn? Ready? Boom. Can't see him. He's there somewhere. Right, anyway. We'll open that even though I'm not bothered what's in it. We'll open that. And then we'll go turn that in. Don't know where you turn it in. Maybe Lunar Bounty Board? Unless you turn it into Jack himself. Jack's office, yeah, you do turn it into Jack. Wowee, right. Ooh. Can't wait to go to Claptastic Voyage now. Come on. Yeah, I might set the papers on Jack's desk alight as well while I'm here. I know this isn't a completionist playthrough, but I like to get as much badass rank as I can while I remember. There we go. Set myself on firelight, but... Well, we're clear. Are we clear? We are... Ah! Oh, there's another one to do. Damn you, Sterwin. Well, we might have to do that then instead of going... To, well, we're not going to Claptastic Voyage in this episode then. No! What a game. Sterwin's back. Well, we could probably clear him up quickly. It's probably better for us not to go to Claptastic Voyage DLC. Already discovered that. Oh, right, he's in Elysia. Damn it, just as we get bloody cleared up, another mission pops up, eh? Well, at least that means we can preserve Claptastic Voyage DLC till the next episode, because to be honest, we'd have only had time to probably just head over there and do the very first, you know, get to the Nexus or something, so at least now we can do this mission, definitely clear everything up, and then do a full Claptastic run next episode. Yeah, it's really not good using these against you, I know. Oh, equip Monster Trap mod. Okay. Monster Trap. Catcher and Ofer. Haha. That is fine by me. Where is she? There you are. Come on, Gitface. Gotta catch him Go! I didn't kill it. What if... Why did she die then? Aha, she's back though. Right, I might not have to get her as far down as I did then. Go. There we go. Another one? Oh, fine, we'll go get another one. Greedy. Should we get Ofer Superior? There's one up there as well, isn't there? That's an Elder Ofer, yeah. He'll want that, I bet.
This is so exciting.
Where is she, though? Elder? Ah, she's there. He's an elder as well. Well, she's definitely more tough. Go! Where the hell's it gone? Are you taking the mick? Where is it? Great. Our Pokeball's gone. What the hell? What? How can I capture her when she's right over there? She's not even dead though, that's the thing. Right, well, that's bugged out. That was so funny. Capture Elder Ofa. Oh, by the way, you've got to fly a mile off the map before you can actually get it. Screw you guys, you trolls. What a buggy ass game. Right, let's get a load more pistol ammo, because the blowfire wasn't doing too bad against her, really. Chipping away at her. Right, we'll have to try this one again then. God damn it, Sturwin, you and your crazy missions. Right, it shouldn't take too long to get back there. That was mad. Derpy Borderlands Part 1. That reminds me of Gettle in Borderlands 2. If you hit Gettle at the right time in Borderlands 2, when he's launching himself towards you, and kill him, he just carries on. Not kill him, sorry, wound him, but like shoot him as he's just about to land. He'll fly an absolute mile. Hopefully other people have experienced that as well. I've seen videos on it before, and it's actually happened to me. It is so funny, it's unreal. Okay. Oh, he got him. Right, he didn't fly a mile this time as well. Victorious Ofa. Right. You want one of each then, dear? I think he's planning on turning up to the Elite Four with just Ofas. Ofas, the Borderlands version of Snorlax.
Unbelievable! Look how cute she is!
Victorious Ofa! Right, let's chip away at you a little bit. Once your shield's down, you should start being a bit easier. Wow, she's a big girl, isn't she? Catch her! Yes!
Oh, you're a smooth bugger, you
are. I know, I'm the Pokemon Master.
Over superior, no less.
Oh, great. This bitch is going to be annoying. Let's get this Shredifier back on for her. Where is it? That'll just... Actually, no, let's get the Torrent on, because it'll strip a shield a bit easier. Right, O for Superior, eh? I'll tell you what, I wish they putty would die. Where are you? Oh, you're a Guardian. Anyway, sod off, I'm off to kill O for Superior. Hello! Wow, you are big. Let's get your shield off then, love. She keeps spitting out Guardians. Right, now let's blowfly it. Blowfly. Where's the blowfly? There we go. Right, I've got to wound her, but not kill her. Putty, sod off. Go! Yes! Don't fly! Oh my god, that's gonna go off the side. Don't go off the side. Don't go off the side. Oh! That was close.
It's not as good for them as being left out in the wild, so it breaks my heart. But it's the only way to ensure this species and its subspecies survive. Thanks, mate.
Alright, mate. Well, let's go to the pickup point then. Grab some ammo while we're here. I tell you what, I just want to kill all putties. Right. Not having this. It's the best way to get rid of putties. wait for them to come towards you, and then just flak them. And it missed both of them. Go away! Right, no, let's get going. We need to go to the holodome. Sod these guys. Oh, they're so annoying. I should have just sniped them, really. Right, let's go to the pickup point then. You're gonna die. Good. Dodge. Wow, what was that? Something pushed me. Right, here we go then. Let's go to the holodome if we're all done with side missions. Yay, we're all done for side missions. Right, holodome it is. Yep, off we go. And it should be at the bottom. Nice. Right, let's go. Hello, Sanctuary. Yay, Gage. That's what I could do with going to them vendors. Right, let's top up on ammo while we're listening to these dudes. Let's equip our grenade mod. Let's go. Let's do some ripping up of Pandora. Really not looking forward to doing this at all. Hopefully they won't be that high a level and I can just tank my way through it, but I can do I've done a holodome before. It's really not that difficult. The ballast round's a bit annoying. Obviously it's ammo consumption that's more frustrating. But here we go. So obviously I've got to get to get into the holodome, and then what I'm going to have to do is set my file to read only, because round one is Flame Knuckle spawns at the end of it. So what I'm going to do is go do that, set that as my read only file, and then we'll come back and we'll do a couple of rounds to farm him. Hopefully it won't take us that long. And why am I opening ammo crates up? There's a vault symbol right there. And yeah, got to enter the holodome. So I'm going to go set my file as read only right now, and then we'll go and farm him. Right guys, I am back and I should be all read-onlyed up. So let's go ahead and get in with this one then. So what are we going to use? I don't know if it matters or whatever. Got to press the holo button. Let's just have a look at some of the weapons we've got. I'm going to keep the blowfly on me, but I mean we've got a skull masher, haven't we? Yeah, I think we're going to go for the skull masher then over the magma. Fatali might be better than the torrent so far. We'll go for that. Unless we can find anything better. Shredifier. ZX1. They're not going to be too good. No. Let's go. Yep. I'm happy with that. Right. Here we go then. What have we got here? Just got a Lost Legion Marine. Let's have a look. These are level 25. So, yeah. This isn't going to be a... Oh, no. Fatali's doing all right, I suppose. We'll stick with the Fatali for now then. In fact, we might try and snipe these guys. Why not? There's no reason why we shouldn't. We can use whatever ammo we want. There we go. There's another one down. Because they're so long distance away, actually. Probably be quicker if we can be precise enough to snipe them. There we go. Till the Guardians come out, that is. We'll use the sniper ammo. They're just too hard to headshot when the heads are on their... where the bollocks should be. Oh, Guardians. I hate Guardians. Oh, I suppose we can crit shot some of them. Hello. Do you want your head popping off? Thank you. Right, who's next? You're next. There we go. Hopefully this won't be too big a round. Right, we've got to do the optional missions as well. So we've got to turn on the jump pads. Right. That's fine. Let's turn that one on. This will probably be the one that gets Flame Knuckle activated. So we'll do that while we kill these people. There's another jump pad somewhere here. Is it up here? No. There's some ammo up here. Oh, it's on the other side. Okay. Right. Slam. We'll leave the ammo crates for now. Yeah, we should go over here, actually. While there's enemies about, we may as well kill them. There we go. Another one there. There's a jump pad around here somewhere. It looks like it's lower down, though. It is. It's there. Jump pad. Boosh! It's annoying having to do this every time, but it's got to be done. Oh, now that was a shot and half, that, wasn't it? Boom. Complete waves 1 of 4. Jesus, this is going to take us a long time. Hopefully, Flame Knuckle will not take the mick with us. Wow, another good no scope there. Got those quick scoping skills, yo. Right there underneath. There's one. Boom. The other one is there. Go away. You're not hurting me. You're just annoying me. Right. There we go. Right, is this one up top or no? It's just here. That should be good. Let's get these out of the way as soon as we can. And then we can concentrate on getting Flame Knuckle. Right. Complete circuits and jump pads are down. Boom. There we go. Right. They're all in this area now. I think they might all be up top, actually. There's another one down. One over here. That's a Lost Legion guy as well. Thinks he can hide, but he can't. She thinks she's hard, but she's not. Boosh. Down the bottom. Ah, there's Flame Knuckle. Oh, so it shouldn't take too long then. Oh, we don't even have to do any of the waves. Right, that's good. That helps us. Because now, all we have to do is kill him. And if we don't get it to drop, then we can quit out. Right, so the sooner we complete them jump pads, the better then. Nukem. Damn you, Flame Knuckle. Oh, yeah, of course. He pops out, doesn't he? Nukem. No Nukem. Right, now, if this has all worked out the way it should have done, I should be able to quit out right now and come back in. In fact, thinking about it, I don't even need to set it as read-only, do I? Because if I haven't completed the round, it should reset. It has. Right, so the whole read-only thing, I don't need to do. Well, my face went. I didn't think about that, actually. I'm sure some of you guys will probably have worked that out before me, actually. But obviously, if I don't complete the wave, then I fail it. So I don't need. Oh, my face went as well. I read-onlyed it, and I need to get the Skullmasher back out and the Vitali. It don't matter. Where's the Vitali gone now? It was right at the top a minute ago. It still is. Well, that don't bother me. We'll just unread-only it when we can. If I don't get this in a couple of runs, I'll be doing it by myself anyway. Right, Holodome, round one. Off we go. Right, hopefully this won't take too long then. Right, oh, so the jump pads come up straight away then. Wow, that's good. Wow, this isn't going to take long at all then. There was me fighting through all these enemies. All I've got to do is turn on the jump pads. Complete circuits, turn on jump pads. So if I just run around and do that, will Flame Knuckle come straight out? You can tell that I didn't like the Holodome very much because I've hardly done it. In fact, since it came out, I do not think I've come back to the Holodome. So I apologise if I'm being a bit newbie right now. I obviously haven't got a clue what I'm doing because I haven't been here in so long. Complete circuits. Boom. Don't need to even jump on the jump pads either, do I? I can just... Yeah, I think I can just slam down on them. Turn them all on. Hey, Oh no, just waiting for the circuit to complete. Wow, what a launch. Look at that. Go on. Oh, I thought I could land on there. Right, so surely now Flame Knuckle should appear. Is that him? It is. Right. Okay, that's fine. So we can just do this. Oh, this ain't going to take as long as I thought I was going to. That's fine. Right, get down. Two runs. Nothing. Well, I don't even need to really switch my weapons or anything then. In fact, can I do this without recording? Let me get my game save up here on my other screen. Save 004, properties, read only, apply, off. Right, let's try that then. I shouldn't have to do anything now. Yeah, Skullmaster and Fatale. Fine. Okay, that means, guys, we could probably go for 5 runs now then. I know it's probably running a bit over time anyway from the half-hour episode I like to do. But screw it, I want to farm Flame Knuckle a few times. So that's 2 runs down anyway. We could probably get... Yeah, we could easily get 2 more at least. Probably... Yeah, we'll probably head to 5 then if it's this easy. And yeah, this will be our legendary for today. And then obviously I've got to get through all the other rounds of the Holodome at some point. Oh, sorry. Hello. I've got to get through all the rest of the ones and then we can do the ballast round at some point. That might not be the next episode, to be fair, but... Wow, that was bad. There we go. Right. Jump pads. Let's go. Wow, my shots. There we go. Jump pads are doing it for themselves. There's another one. This is going to be nice and easy. This one's down below, isn't it? Yes. I think. Nope, this one is up top. Right, this one's down below, though. Right, we'll go for this one, and then we'll go for the other one. Flame Knuckle appears over there, we've worked out now. So, we should be able to get it nice and quickly if he appears on that platform. Right, here we go then. Let's activate this last switch. Flame Knuckle should appear on here somewhere. I think. Activate, thank you. He's over there. Boom, right. And hopefully the Nukem will not fall into the abyss. Right, straight for your head. This is run number 3. Stuff falling out everywhere. It's really not... Oh, hello. Okay. Well, that's annoying. Jump down. Huh, didn't do out then. Right, nothing fell down here though. That's what I was going to ask, because Flame Knuckle did. Probably do a goading him. You can't get back up there from there, can you? Oh, yes, you can. You got to charge it though, haven't you? Yeah. Right. Somebody need to push me off again. Will you sod off while I check my loot? Thank you. Right. It was just a white and I hate these guardians. It was just a white and a green. Well, there's 3 runs down anyway. God, I can't believe how quick and simple it is. I thought you had to go through the whole 3 or 4 waves. I didn't realise you could get him on the first wave. I was dreading this one and no need at all. Right, well, there's 3 runs anyway. So I reckon we can get 2 more done if we're quick. Definitely. And then if nothing drops, then yeah, it will be off-camera farming time, and I'll have to do it all by myself. But it shouldn't be too difficult, really. Especially at this rate. I mean, it's still a good 3 or 4 minute farm, but at least you've got stuff to do while you're waiting. You know, it's not just running all the way there. You can actually jump on the jump pads. And I know that sounds stupid, but, you know, like something like a Captain Flint farm in Borderlands 2, it's just boring. You're just running, really. I know I'm just running around now, but at least you've actually got a goal. Oh, God, I was trying to cheat then, but you've got to go and enter... you've got to go and enter the jump pads, haven't you?
Deadlift was obsessed with jump pads. The only way we could beat it was to join it.
Yeah, jump pads just kind of came.
Right, there's one. Boom. Whatever's got that big beastie shotgun has ripped through my shield. But luckily it's fast recharging. I like this. Just running around, skipping things out. Yeah, we don't want to fight anyone. We just want to jump on pads. Boom. Right, this one's down below. Can get to it from here though, can't I? Yes, I can. Boom. If I can make this, I will be amazed. Go on. And he's done it. Right, deadlift. Sorry, flame knuckle, where are you? Where are you, sunshine? Where is he? Does he spawn in different places? That's him over there, isn't it? Yes, it is. Right. Wow, that took your shield straight down though, didn't it, eh? Freeze you if we can. Freeze! Wow, stuff went everywhere then. But I didn't see. Did not see a launch come out of there, I will admit. But I'll just check around just in case. No. It was a white. God damn you! Right, okay. We'll have to keep an eye out for that then, because his loot tends to fly. And we don't want him up on one of them top pads if it does. So I think it's a good idea to lure him away from that. But let's go for our final farm then of today's live commentary anyway. And then, like I said in the last episode, I will just carry on until we get something good. Well, I'll carry on until we get the Nukem, obviously, but... And then I'll bring you guys that run right there. So let's go for the fifth and final run, like I said. It's having a nice fly, isn't it? Here we go then. Run number five. Let's get to Claptrap. Oh, sorry. His name's not Claptrap, is it? It's Holotrap. Holotrap. Whee, straight down. Right. Nice and quick this time. Jump pads.
Deadlift was obsessed with jump pads. The only way we could beat him was to join him.
Yeah, jump pads just kind of came with the whole Holodome package.
Nice. Right. It's that guy with that annoying weapon again, isn't it? Yes, it is. And he's pretty good with it as well. I'll give him his due. Right. We're away from him now, though, at least. Such a disappointing DLC, this. I'll be honest. No one can sit there. Then again, saying that, I say it's a disappointing DLC, but look what came out of it. I mean, they made Flame Knuckle respawnable, which was a big problem at the time. Flame Knuckle... sorry, not Flame Knuckle wasn't a big problem, but the actual refarmable bosses. So they did kind of put one extra refarmable boss into the game. Then there was the chance of getting the Nukem, obviously, that is another thing. Then there was the Holodome, the Berrigan in the Ballast Round. That was an extra legendary, so that wasn't too bad. Don't go on the jump pad. So So that one too bad, yeah. And the T4SRs, I mean, they came out of it as well. A load of other things as well, but I mean, the T4SRs were brilliant. So it's not all bad, do you know what I mean? There was a few positives to the negative. So I'll give them the due on that one. It wasn't the worst thing in the world, but the whole mechanics around it were just absolutely shocking. Right, Fame Knuckle, let's concentrate. Let's get you towards that side. Here we go then, straight for your head. Off, off, off with your head. Right, let's see when the loot comes out. It does fly everywhere, doesn't it? But no, there was no... there was definitely no Nukem in that one either. You'd see it pretty clearly, and a launcher would not fly that far. It's just money and moonstones. Anyway, guys, I'm going to continue to farm this by myself right now. And yeah, I will see you guys back when I actually get it. So that's 5 runs down. No matter how long it takes, I'll get it. And the next run will be the Nukem drop. So I'll see you guys then. Right, guys, we have a problem here. This doesn't happen too often, but it seems to happen in the pre-sequel more than anything else. But as you can see, this is run number 120. I've done this ridiculous amount of times now. It's taken me absolutely ages. It's unreal, which I do not mind in the legendary runs. But in the Holodome, you look it up anywhere, Flame Knuckle is supposed to drop this thing like wildfire. Absolute wildfire. I've watched loads of videos on it. I've done some research because I thought, this is something not right here. 120 runs and nothing. It just drops the same old white and green weapon every single time I've done this now for 120 runs. No difference in it, no different rarities or anything like that. Watch videos on it, and sure enough, these guys are going in straight away and getting them to drop in true and ultimate Vault Hunter mode. But we are not in true or ultimate Vault Hunter mode, we are in normal mode. And I've experienced this before with Benjamin Blue, if you guys remember. I farmed him in for videos in true and ultimate Vault Hunter mode, and he drops legendaries, and he's not even supposed to. He doesn't have a legendary drop assigned to him, it's just random world drops. And I was getting them more frequently than I am this. But yeah, when we tried to do it in normal mode, it just didn't work. I did that over 100, maybe 200 times, I think it was, something like that. And we got absolutely nothing. So what I am concluding in this, I may be wrong, and if I am wrong, please let me know. But what I'm concluding in this is that in Holodome round one, in normal mode, Flame Knuckle does not drop, first wave does not drop the Nukem. 120 runs is ridiculous for a guy like this. Like I said, I'm not bothered about RNG mechanics, but I know the pre-sequel pretty well by now, and I know he's supposed to drop it. So I made run one number 120, my last run. If he didn't drop it, then I wasn't going to go any further. And what I'm going to do is apologise to you guys that we cannot have a legendary drop in this episode. It's getting on now, this episode. So I'm going to end it now by saying we're not going to have a legendary drop, but I will make it up to you guys in the next episode. And what we're going to do is we're still going to go for the Nukem. We're going to go to True Vault Hunter mode just for one half of, you know, the very beginning of the episode. We'll get to Flame Knuckle, we'll get that Nukem drop, and then we'll come back into normal mode, and we'll go ahead and carry on our farm. So we've still got loads of things to do as well. We've got the whole Claptastic Voyage DLC to do. We've got the legendary grenades to get from the Torgs and from the Krakens. So yeah, we can go ahead and do that. We've got all the Claptastic Voyage DLC weapons to get as well, all sorts of things like that. So yeah, next episode we will probably have a double legendary drop next episode. I think I'll go for Flame Knuckle at the beginning of the episode for that Nukem. We'll get the Nukem definitely, and then we'll probably end up maybe firing for one of the legendary grenades. So we'll try and get a badass Kragan spawn, and we'll go for that Four Seasons or something like that. But anyway, guys, like I said, once again, I do apologise. He's not dropped yet. He should have dropped it at 120 runs, definitely. He should have dropped about 12 by then. But I carried on anyway, and I persisted. But I'm pretty sure he doesn't drop it in normal mode. But like I said, if anyone has had it drop in Holodome, I might keep trying. And if we can get it, maybe I'll bring it in the next episode. But I want to end this episode off right now. So thanks for watching, everyone. And yeah, we'll see you for a double drop in the next episode.